All right, I can finally get back to it. Okay. All right, let's do it.
More crystallized stone. That must be the way back to the map chamber.
I like step through. Someone met the other. Never mind.
What have we here?
I'm a student at Hogwarts, sir. And this is Professor Fig.
Professor Charles Rookwood at your service. Has someone completed the first trial?
I have, Professor Rookwood. You look familiar, sir.
I imagine you saw me in the first pensive you accessed, in Gringotts. So, you found the portkey to access Professor Rackham's vault, and you deciphered the map within the locket you found floating above that pensive.
I did. I found something that I can't identify floating above the last pensive.
Ah, yes. You will find a similar artifact in each trial. You must take care to keep them safe. You'll need them to complete the journey we have set forth for you. Once you have them all, we will tell you what to do with them.
Very well. Are you able to tell me anything about the next trial?
Before you proceed, I would like to speak with Charles regarding the urgent situation involving the goblins.
The goblins?
The student has seen traces of a powerful dark magic being wielded by goblin kind. They and their mentor, Professor Fig, not only encountered goblins lurking outside of San Bakar's tower, they also encountered a powerful goblin in my vault at Gringotts.
I'm afraid it would be wise to halt the trials until we know more.
We shall defer to you in this matter.
Of course.
Now then.
Wait, Professor. The name Rookwood. Do you think...
that there's a connection to Victor? Perhaps. But we can't be sure of its significance, if any. For now... tell me what you saw in the pensive.
Before the witch from the last pensive, Isadora, became a Hogwarts professor, she argued with Professor Rackham about using magic to remove pain.
Hopefully the next pensive provides more context. For now, we should learn what Ramrock knows. I will be honest, I've no idea where to start.
Actually, I might know of someone. I saw Serona at the Three Broomsticks speaking to a goblin once. They seemed friendly.
Well, it's worth a try. See what you can find out. Of course, don't forget...
my studies. Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah.
Before you go...
yes?
Professor?
Have you encountered swirling traces of magic in the world? Aside from those along our path?
Not that I recall. What are they?
Evidence of the Keeper's efforts to manipulate the power of ancient magic during our time. If I am correct, and I usually am, you should be able to use them to inform and enhance your own magic.
Thank you, sir. I will look out for them.
Interesting. This game looks so pretty. Oh, we're in the fall now? Like we're in summer before? I guess it's been some time, I think. Maybe? I'm not sure. XIV 10, 7, 17. Oh, 13. Wait. Oh, no. I'm sorry. IV's 4. That's 13, 14. 11, 12. Oh, okay. Not sure why they're named like
I should
that.
Ask Serona at the Three Broomsticks about the goblin she was talking to the day of the troll attack.
Should. But Lumos. That's what we're gonna do. We, my friend. Caretaker's Luna. Gladwin Moo, the Hogwarts caretaker, wishes to speak with me about something. She's finding me at the reception hall or. Beast class, yes. I get this. I should be able to get a mount now. I was gonna say I can get a Gryffindor, but not a Gryffindor, oh crap, what are they called? Why is this? It's like on the tip of my tongue. It's like an H, or, I don't know. It'll probably be told to me here in a moment.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
What is it called?
Welcome, everyone.
It's a dodo.
I see you've already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous, especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howen. Hello, I'm Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howen's speech. She over-exaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe. Oh!
Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a puffskin can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor. Here. You can practice on Gerald. Just keep an eye out for his tongue.
why he look like that?
You can use my brush. Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. Do you think it enriches his experience? That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed? What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think.
What
I think we can safely
thing?
Say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is.
He's got big fucking
kindness
eyes.
Is one of his best qualities, right after ambition and cleanliness.
Ambition?
Good
How can
work, everyone.
Literal furball
now,
have ambition.
Let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
This way. The Neasels are over here.
Yo, those fat cats look like they can easily climb that fence. Why are they not? Oh, maybe it's magic.
Oh, couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeydukes. Stupid thing.
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Ugh, tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent?
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone!
That's really not funny.
Let's go.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on. Feed and brush the Neasels just as you did with Gerald. The Neasels really took to you. They know a good egg when they see one. As do I.
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and see yourselves out. Now, where is our new student? Ah, there you are. I would like a moment, please.
I guess so.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast's lesson?
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Good. You seem to understand that when beasts are properly controlled, they can play a vital role in our lives. Some provide us with magically imbued materials, if cared for correctly, which does not include torturing them for whiskers. Well done, by the way. Probably best to let me handle it next time.
Yes, Professor.
They're nearly as bad as the savagers in Rookwood's poacher pack. Sadly, we're the ones who suffer, stumbling over dead beasts. Terrible waste of resources.
Surely the poachers can be brought to justice by someone. The Ministry, perhaps?
An optimistic idea. Now, why don't we focus on more immediate matters that we can control? Professor Weasley has asked that I prepare some assignments designed to help you catch up to the other fifth years. Be on the lookout for my owl. Meanwhile, I also encourage you to study as many beasts as you can on your own time.
No. Yes.
Hey, over here. Come on.
Oh, here we go. Are we getting into trouble?
Do you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying something to those brutes so that I didn't have to. You were an augury at noon in the desert.
I certainly hope that's a good thing.
It's something my gran and I say. It means that something or someone is a welcome surprise. At least, that's what we decided it meant.
I couldn't stand there and watch them harm the poor thing.
We're of a similar mind. Actually, in light of that, there's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
I knew it was coming.
Very well.
This fucking class.
I hoped I would.
You go to a new class, you do the class, learn a couple buttons, get some weird
thing. I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Really?
And then,
well, thank you.
You get in trouble with some random classmate.
As I said, we think alike. Pleasant surprise.
I don't know. What is it called? This thing. I don't know what it's called. I'm pretty sure that's what we're gonna get.
Quite the weather we're having, don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking?
It really is much better if I just show you.
I know their
don't
name.
Don't worry, we're nearly there.
Oh,
it's
I know their
ahead.
Name, and that's what bothers me. Oh, but I want one.
Stand back.
100% that's what we're doing right now. Yep, there's some big ass wings.
Please meet Highwing. Isn't she just magnificent? Go on, introduce yourself to her. But be careful.
Hippogriff.
You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them. Someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like. I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's going on in the castle. You wouldn't know from looking at her, but she's a dreadful busybody.
Yeah. Hippogriff.
So, what did you think of Highwing?
Brilliant.
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn Hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story, but I rescued her from poachers a few years back. Got her to safety and, well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again. And I might not be there next time.
Professor Howen mentioned the poachers as well. She seemed to imply that we couldn't rely on the Ministry to help.
I don't often agree with Professor Howen, but on that, I fear she's right. The poachers' influence is growing. I see them every day in the village, lingering, talking to people. They're up to something. I'm just not sure what.
That does seem strange. Sounds as if they're planning something.
Exactly. I think I'm going to look into it. Find out what's going on. What they're doing.
I think that's a fine idea. Information is power.
And the more I know, the better I can keep Highwing safe.
You seem undeterred. Will you let me know what you find out?
Oh, I will slaughter half the world to protect
Highwing. I should
Highwing.
Be going, but we'll speak again
Don't
soon.
Don't you touch my friend. I'll fuck you in the butthole. Force and control spells help you juggle
smaller. You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
I believe you. Oh, is someone gonna teach me about these frickin' doors? It's this guy.
Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwin Moon, Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there?
Oh,
watch what happens when that light changes from day to night.
Oh.
Now, if you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Ooh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally,
Revelio
can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most.
Lumos.
This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes, terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go... Perhaps you could start simply by removing them, so I can go about my evening duties.
Yeah,
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
No.
Curfew? Oh, tosh! I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck.
One in Professor Fig's office. I remember that one. Oh, I get Alohomora finally. Finally, man. I think so. Disillusionment is a good one, and then what is this? Oh, I don't actually have to equip it. I can just go up to it.
Alohomora.
Oh, it's like a thing. Use Q and E and A and D to move this. What the? Wait, what am I doing? I'm so confused. Wait, hold on, what? I don't know what I'm doing. What? Oh, am I just looking for the bits that move? Oh.
Well done. You're in. Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle, after all.
Alohomora.
Oh, okay, I got it. Oh. This is red. There we go. Okay. Yeah. So you just gotta find the part where things move. Dear Mirabelle, my dear Dot has been asking for your prompts. I can convince her to stop in the for a butterbeer or two if you were to join us within Sparking Long. When do you manage to come by? I wonder. Serena. No idea whose bedroom I'm searching, but I'm searching it. Was there even anyone in here? Thank you.
I'd say.
Super.
You say that every year, Matilda.
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
Anyway, I'm not afraid of a goblin rebellion. My marching professor Hecate is superb. I'm not students in the hospital wing on account of my venomous tentacular.
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls. I begin my rounds now.
I scared Professor Hecate.
Ravenclaw? My dear winning bet. And Ravenclaw would not have been that. Not this year, anyway. What was what?
Dun, dun, dun. I got greedy. I shouldn't have tried to grab the page.
I'm terribly disappointed about Quidditch being cancelled.
Huh. I had planned to bet a few galleons on Hufflepuff.
Many assume this to be the shell of a fire crab native to Fiji. However, those in the know swear it's bejeweled by a tortoise shell. It's a bejeweled tortoise shell created by a mad wizard named Versailles, when his chateau was overrun by Nifflers. The dazzling shell was carried off years later by a Hogwarts professor on holiday in the Ardennes.
Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
It's definitely intriguing. I'd like to help you solve this mystery.
You, my friend, are a gentle person and a scholar. And I have something to offer in exchange. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
How many statues are there to find?
I don't know precisely, but I've spotted dozens. Seems they're everywhere I look. You have your work cut out for you, if you were to ever unravel their meaning.
You mentioned offering something in exchange for my assistance.
I did. Once you've brought me enough moons, I'll show you even more powerful forms of Alohomora. Not every lock is as easy to pick as the Faculty Towers.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Oh, I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery.
Aye, aye, Captain.
We are fortunate to have a student brave enough.
Sneak. No! Come here, kitty! Oh, hello.
Revelio.
Something's dinging. I really want to know what these are.
Confringo
doesn't
Expelliarmus.
Work. And they don't work.
Levioso.
Oh! Oh! I just tried that for... Okay, well... Alright. Levioso is what you use. Quests. The helm of Osmead. Okay. Right, I have these assignments though. Light. Let me just see if maybe he's got anything different. Watch him be there. It's like my time. That would be late. Kind of a version breaker. What appears to be a second year. Why is it always focused on that? Okay, he's not. I was going to say, what appears to be a first or a second year is just chilling around.
Hello, Lucan. I'd like to practice with the training dummy.
Excellent idea. This...
That'd be brilliant.
Wonderful.
Yep. I know you're just gonna tell me about practice. I don't really have. I have the pulso on that one.
Accio.
I'm gonna have to actually set this one up. So. It's a 4-3-1.
Confringo!
Keep trying!
Sorry. It's a 2.
That was something.
I'm losing my mind.
Accio. Incendio. Levioso.
There we go.
Excellent form.
Accio. Incendio.
Good one.
here. Insane. Leviosa. Accio. Incendio.
That's it. Impressive woodwork. I take to face you in a duel.
Thanks, Lucan. You've been a great help.
Oh, stop. Don't make me blush. Seriously, well done. Training dummies will think twice before challenging you again. Even though you won the tournament already, I'm glad to see you haven't stopped training. Stay sharp, my friend.
Let me in this bitch.
Lumos.
In the courtyard. Okay. Where's the bank that way? No, it's not. It's over here. Oh, okay. There it is.
Homura. Lumos.
What? Like an owl.
Revelio.
Oh, whoops. Let's go here. I feel like there's a reason it's like that. Hold on. And what might you be? I need a key for you.
Revelio.
Something got revealed. A chest there.
Confringo.
Hmm.
Revelio.
No. Give me that. While the moving gears of contrast and mechanic service determine many others. That'll take me that way. I'd rather next.
Aloha, Mora.
Is this where I was earlier?
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Level 2 lock. Why are you making noise?
Revelio.
Magic unicorn, the fountain gives an air serenity calm. See the places that you recognize here in the movie. Okay. Alright. I still have a lot of quests. Pop balloons over Hogsmeade Station. Conjured a number of balloons. She wants me to use my broom to reach and pop. Okay. Professor Garlic's assignment. Use a venomous tarantula. Defendo. I need to do this. Do this. Oh, that hogs me.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Hello, Serona.
Hello, Miss Ryan. I wanted to thank you again for your help with Rookwood and Harlow the day of the troll attack.
Serona, please. And I was happy to help. Oh, those two are nothing but trouble. Glad you and your friend were here when they found you.
I am too. You were speaking to a goblin here that day.
Yes, Lodgog. He's a friend.
It seems as though you were on good terms with him.
I've known him for years. We met when I was waiting tables here as a student, well before I bought the place. He was cordial enough, but we weren't friends then. His mistrust of wizard kind ran deep.
But you're friends now?
We are. I hadn't seen him in years when he came in a few months ago. But he recognized me instantly, which is more than I can say for some of my own classmates. Took them a second to realize I was actually a witch, not a wizard. Not all goblins are like Ranrock and his loyalists. Lodgok is as worried as the rest of us about what's been going on.
In that case, I'd like to talk with him, about Ranrock in particular. Where might I find him?
I assume your interest is to do with the rumors I've heard about Ranrock working with our friend Rookwood.
It is.
If he's not here, you might find him doing business at the Hog's Head. He's a trusted metal trader. You should mention that we spoke. He can, understandably, be wary of witches and wizards. even ones as young as you. That said, if you're looking for information on Ranrok to help rein him in, you'll find an ally in Lodgok.
Thank you, Serona.
If you find Lodgok, please give him my best. I don't know what you've done to make such powerful enemies, but please, watch your back.
Hello! Good to see you outside the castle.
You too, Amit.
Welcome to the Og's Head. Any empty seat is yours.
Hello, Lodgok. Serona said I might find you here.
She did she? Did she send you with news?
No, actually, I wanted to speak with you. It's about Ranrok.
Now I remember. The three broomsticks. Day of the troll attack. You're the student he's after.
I am. And I need to know what he and his loyalists are up to, so I can stay a step ahead.
Let's say I did know. Why should I trust you?
Serona trusts me, and she thought our interests may be aligned.
Well, if Serona trusts you, very well. I may know of something that could help us both. A way to get Ranrok to confide his plans to me.
I'm listening.
Years ago, a heinous witch stole a sacred goblin relic. Rumor has it that it now rests in her sarcophagus, in a tomb accessible only by wizard kind. Ranrok and I had a falling out a while back. The relic could well repair the chasm between us.
Okay. What is this relic?
Very well. I'll retrieve the relic if you promise to share Ranrok's plans with me.
We will have to trust each other. I, that you will not abscond with the relic, and you, that I'll share what I learn. Gather whatever supplies you may need and meet me near the witch's tomb.
Okay. Where is said tomb? Oh, not that far. Okay. Thought that was Rookwood, and I was confused. It's like, why is Homie just chilling in the street?
I'm ready.
Good. There's no time to lose.
I wonder if we'll ever get to go to, like, Diagon Alley. I mean, we went to Green.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Urtgot. The witch considered herself a collector and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind see things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today.
The tombs surrounding Hogwarts. I wonder. This game feels good as an open world game. You know, does it really need to be an open world game? Like, what if it? Sometimes I think just a straight-up linear, single path experience.
The witch's tomb.
Dreadful-looking place, isn't it?
A mediocre open world, open-ended story type crap, but
You can't imagine.
I wish you luck retrieving the helmet. As a wand carrier, you should have an advantage. Now, before you set off, do you have any questions?
It seems Ranrock and Rookwood are conspiring. Why would that be?
I had heard this. When the dark-hearted conspire, they seldom make their full intentions clear to one another. I can only speculate, but I imagine their alliance is uneasy and quite fragile. Let us hope that ours is less so.
What about this helmet makes it so special?
The helmet of Urtgot is an ancient and storied relic, forged during a time of unity among the goblin clans. It inspired greatness, that is, until it was no longer ours. Then it became something else. A symbol of what has been lost, of all that wizardkind has taken from us. Reclaiming it would mean a great deal to goblin kind and to Ranrock. He would be grateful to me should I return it.
Okay.
It all seems clear to me now that we're here.
I do hope our alliance proves fruitful. Again, I wish you luck. I will remain here, eagerly awaiting your return. Please, be careful.
I'll dress myself up like the pretty princess that I am. There we go. Into the cave! This is a dungeon. This feels like a dungeon. Just because I can and I love the noise.
Lumos.
Aw, man, come on. Give me more reasons to use this super cool spell.
It's sealed.
Oh, hey. It's got the... Okay, let's see what I'm doing.
Moths. Curious.
Snipple on up.
Merlin's beard.
Oh wait, is this that area for the snake?
This can't be the witch's tomb. Likely I need to go further.
I see you.
Lumos!
Why.
Protego!
Goblin.
Lumos!
I could not enter. Real quick, I just wanna grab all this stuff.
Compulsor! Lumos.
Oh, well, I didn't mean to do that.
I have a feeling I'm not alone here.
Was that good? Unlucky, but good timing? There's zombies? And fairy must be struck with fire spells to make them vulnerable to attack. Okay, in that case, can I press escape real quick? Where is talents? Dark arts? No, core. Oh, do I already have it? Oh wait, no, was it in spells? Or was it this one? Yeah, give me that. And then I'll grab this also one.
Incendio.
These inferior horrible.
Thank you.
There we go. Smaller skulls. Up here. No. I'm gonna say, I know there's something up here. That's quite unfortunate. Alright, you know what? Here, hold on. Escape. Gear. This one. Worth 200. This one is better, so we're. Okay. This is not worth anything, though. Headway. Honestly, yeah, I'm not. That's a no. I'll just destroy him. I don't care for it. These are 90, so we'll keep those. Wait, you're 29, you're 29. Oh, wait, hold on. But I might as well wear you, get rid of you, and then sell the blues. That makes more sense. Value. Is this the one I have equipped? Not the one I have equipped. This is the one I have equipped. This one's 32. For the green. Headwear. No. Okay, and then let me go back and actually check that. See if that was anything worth grabbing. Probably not, but cold dragon eye spectacles. Oh lord. My gear, glasses. That is goofy. That is goofy and silly. What is this? Oh, I'm hearing moth noises.
Levioso!
Oh.
Lumos.
What?
If I could power it somehow, it looks like it could be rotated.
Protego! Lumos!
Overthinking it. Wait, what?
Lumos.
Oh. I did not understand what I was doing at all. Let it work. I am smart. There we go. Give me that money.
What's that hanging there? Looks precarious. Down I go. No other way.
Revelio. Deposit.
I didn't just jump down. Neck item.
Accio.
What's in the box? A collection of pioneer tool stuff. Oh, neat. Alright. There's some last.
Revelio.
Broke that. There. Okay, wait, what is that? Hold on. Is that the way I came from? Hmm. Oh, yeah. Never mind. Ian, let's go in.
Oh.
I think there are two ways. Tell me to go that way, so. Go this way. Meow.
Accio.
Okay. I thought that was coming from the way I came from, but it was not. That was the way to get back up. Got it. Okay. Puzzle. Puzzle time, puzzle time.
Lumos.
We have one here.
Incendio. The table. Stupid one. Stupid one.
I'm...
Ah! Stupefy! Levioso! Stupefy! Incendio!
Cut down the...
Confringo! Incendio! Protego! Stupefy! Stupefy!
Oh! Oh, I died. I couldn't see. Damn it! The whole they need to be on fire. I keep forgetting. My four is a. It is a fire spell, right?
Confringo.
It is a fire spell.
Protego. Stupefy. Incendio. Stupefy. Confringo. Stupefy. Accio. Incendio.
Spamming buttons. Okay. Let's try this again.
Let me also. Incendio.
Target.
Stupefy. Incendio. Stupefy. Confringo. Incendio. Stupefy. Protego. Stupefy. Stupefy. Incendio.
Oh, I got double hit. Ugh, that's unfortunate. If the controls to like target weren't absolutely stupid, I'd probably use them. Put both my hands on my keyboard.
Let me also.
Wrong button. I forget.
Potato. Stupid. Incendio. Stupid. Stupid. Stupid.
I don't get somebody.
Confringo.
I can't guard. If you get hit, you cannot guard. Ugh. I can't believe I'm having more difficult with these guys than I have any other boss. That's hilarious. It's the stupid gimmick with the fire. One off.
Confringo.
Confringo him.
Confringo.
Incendio. come on, dude. I can't dodge mid-dodge.
Incendio.
Potato. Yeah. I'm panic drinking. Oh my. My ew. Oh. Oh. There's more? Oh, mommy.
Confringo. Incendio.
Okay. Oof. Ooh-wee, mommy. Like 9, 10 dudes here? 10? Yeah, 10? Mother fricker, dude. That was no mean to like.
Lumos.
Okay. Oh, there's 12 or 11?
Catalto!
Climb it. What? Why'd you take so long to climb
Lumos.
It?
Lumos.
Wait, not Lumos.
Catalto! Lumos.
What does this look like? Gear, headgear. It kind of looked like his. Okay. Gotta get
Lumos.
Him. Because I can't cast two spells at once.
Lumos.
All right, now how do we get you? Do I depulso and steal?
Depulso. Lumos. Protego. Lumos. This looks even more complex. Revelio.
What am I forgetting here? Oh, there's one right there.
Depulso.
Hello? Hello? Okay.
Lumos.
I didn't know there was one right there. Okay. There we go.
Witch's final resting place. Lodgok said the helmet was in her sarcophagus.
Okay. There's gonna be more. What? There's a lot of dead dudes here. Like, recently dead.
A dead Ashwinder. You'll better show this to Lodgok. There must be some sort of mechanism for this doorway.
Ranrock already sent some people to come and get the thing. What I would take from this to understand.
Lodgok, the sarcophagus had been raided. I found no helmet, only a dead Ashwinder.
Damn! They got here first! We need to get it before Rookwood uses it to further ingratiate himself to Ranrock. I saw one of their campsites not far from here, but I fear you must go in alone. My fighting days are behind me.
I'll head there now.
Good. There's no time to lose. Get to that helmet before Rookwood does, or we will lose our chance at any leverage, no matter how small, with Ranrok. To think those wretched thieves have their hands on such a relic.
Whoa. Ah! I'm pretty sure I fucked these guys earlier.
You're going to regret that.
Oh, there's a troll.
There they are. The Ashwells.
Pay for your deed.
Nope. I'm not gonna make the board strong. That is significantly higher level than mine.
Stop right there. Expulso! Expulso!
I can't tell what's going on. Oh, he's deposing.
Expulso! Look what you've done! You pay for it.
I have to like sneak up in there. That's all I can really do. There are fighting.
That's it.
This is for Rookwood.
There must be some students at Hogwarts that we could recruit. My loyalty to Rookwood and no one else.
Okay. Not sure what just happened.
Wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. I retrieved the helmet from the Ashwinders.
Well done. This is sure to impress Ranrok. The helmet shines even more brightly than I imagined. The etchings, the contour of the profile. Remarkable.
It looks stunning, Lodgok. I see why you wanted it back.
You did the thieves a service by recovering it. I know many a goblin who would have killed for it.
Ah, then I am glad to be rid of it myself.
Thank you. This should earn Ranrok's trust. I will take it to him immediately. It may distract him from his search.
His search?
It is merely an inkling. You have impressed me greatly, friend. I am glad that I trusted you. We shall speak soon. Best to keep our arrangement quiet for now. Many will not believe that our aims might possibly be aligned.
Interesting. Okay. Well, that's the end of this one.